Well, good afternoon and welcome to Herman University, where we never lose because we're always learning. I have a special guest here today, Apple investor, neighbor of mine, and also a follower of pool all across the world, actually, a real passionate nut, as I am. Welcome, Ernie.
I'm ready.
Nice to see you today. Ernie can help you out if you want to make some money in the stock market. He pretty much knows what he's doing. And what you don't know will cost you a lot of money, but what you do know can make you a lot of money. Check him out. What's your site where they can find you, Ernie?
It's programmedtrader.com.
Let me put that in here.
Programmed Trader. So it's past tense.
.com?
Yeah.
Okay. I hope that went in. It should. So anybody that's interested in buying some oil, which I would highly suggest right now, actually. would you, Ernie, suggest if somebody didn't have oil? I think, you know, it makes sense to buy oil. I mean, if you already have oil, you probably would sell, you know. But if you don't have it...
I never want to sell at the bottom. That's like giving it away.
Well, I mean, we think it's going to go down, though. I mean, so if you did sell now, if you're holding oil, I'm saying it's not a bad time
to
sell.
Take small positions. And if you can keep on buying on the way down in nice, tiny positions, that's probably the way to go.
Okay, and there you go, folks. Early morning tip. And we're going to probably play nine ball tonight. I know Kerry has been contacting me about the show and the nine on the spot, and the break plan, and he's been real curious as to what my break plan is. And I've explained it a lot, but we'll go over it again today on the break. We got the nine on the spot, and we're going to break from the box. Very unusual to be breaking from the box. If you notice the tournament over in Europe, the Great Britain Nine Ball Tour, they break from anywhere with the nine on the spot, where in the Moscone Cup, you had to break from the box, I believe, last year. That wasn't it prior. I'm not sure if they actually did have to break from the box. I would think so. But today, I think we'll play the European style, where you don't have to break from the box. We'll play break from anywhere. And that, of course, is going to make the break a lot easier to make balls and run out. So hope you enjoy, and I'll play a little fun album for you that used to be one of my favorites by Katy Malua, the Russian girl.
I won't spend my life waiting for an angel to descend, searching for a rainbow with a name. Now that I've found you, I'll call off the search, and I won't spend my life gazing at the stars up in the sky, wondering if the will pass me by. Now that I found you, I'll call off the sun. My own. never have known this world that I see today. And I've got a feeling it won't fade away. And I won't end my days wishing that love would come on.
You know, that's a sharp air that you don't want to ignore. Because the cue ball handling is really bad. And that's because the technique was bad. You concentrated on making the ball, and you lost all handle of the shot. That shot has to have cue ball handle with it. And when it doesn't, it's just a matter of time before you're just going to be putting yourself in a hole. So what you want to concentrate on is not as much making the, 50% of it's making the ball. But you got to put another 50% into handling the cue ball. And you can't be roughing it. That's the biggest issue.
Now that I've found you, I'll call you the sun. That I found you, I'll call.
Okay, what would you do that cue ball after I just told you? Again, I said everything that I said did the exact opposite. Rust it up, didn't handle this at all. And it's like I said, I don't have to do anything because you're going to beat yourself every time.
That happened down at Steinway.
Right. Yeah, you said, if I ran out and I didn't read you all those easy shots, I would have done a lot better.
I know, I'd run like 6-7 balls and give you the last two.
Exactly, because you were totally only concentrating on making the ball. You really weren't playing shots. So it really had nothing to do with you running 5 balls. You actually had no chance of winning. Because of the approach that you use.
So I stopped one day, I figured out I'll quit my job without a shadow of a doubt. Sing the blues that I know about. My life is just a slow
drink. It's not important to make that ball.
Minute after minute, second after second, hour after hour goes by. Working for a rich ghost. Never stop to wonder why. So here I am in London town, the greatest thing I'm gonna be around. The kind of music that won't bring me down. My life is just a slow train crawling up a hill. Just a slow train. Oh.
saxophone screen. See you later.
How can nothing come standing strong, yet feel the air beneath my feet? How can happiness feel so wrong? How can misery feel so sweet? You sleep, then break my dreams the way you do. How can I have got in so deep? Why did I fall in love with you? This is the closest thing to crazy I have ever been. 22, acting 17. This is the nearest thing to crazy I have ever known. I was never crazy on my own, and now I know that there's a link between. To craziness and being close to you. How can you make me fall apart, then break my fall with loving lies? It's so easy to break a heart. It's so easy to close your eyes. How can you treat me like a child? Yet like a child I yearn for you. How can anyone feel so wild? How can anyone feel so blue? This is the closest thing to crazy I have ever been. Feeling 22, acting 17. And being close to you. Yeah. say that oysters make you come on strong. But I don't buy it, I don't believe my diet turns me on. Won't take no peas, that's the last thing that I need to do. I can't deny it, my aphrodisiac is you. Alright, I could sniff some powder, I know. And go to bed in rubber gloves, but I don't need no stimulation, potion bomb or imprecation. I'm in love, you know the words. Don't smoke no grass or opium from old Hong Kong. That hubble bubble just makes me see you double. Oh my Lord, don't waste my time with Spanish guy and roots to chew. They cause me trouble because my aphrodisiac is you. When the whole night you're crying. But you cannot forget him. Soon you even stop trying. You walk the floor and wear out your shoes when you feel your heart. You're learning the I got a ticket to the Fast City.
Where the
bells don't really
areas that don't really make sense.
Getting
story.
Off the plane, the cold air rushes like
so
my brain.
Can't be looking at this for 25 minutes and not seeing
it. And I'm divided between penguins and cats, but it's not a borrowed animal. Fly, it's about dying nine times. Walked on Broadway, going up to fall. Where the old man I used to know. The paintings on the walls of release are colorful, but they are no routine. And I'm divided between penguins and cats, but it's not about war. It's about being able to fly. It's about dying nine times. It's about being able to fly. It's about dying nine times.
There is one thing for sure, that we are all going to die.
There is for sure with me.
Yeah, you're going to live forever?
I don't know. I'm
dead. Jury's still out?
Stand empty,
a pale dead moon in a sky streaked with gray. Human kindness is overflowing, and I think it's going to rain today. Scarecrows dressed in the latest styles, with frozen smiles to chase love away. Human kindness is overflowing, and I think it's going to rain today. Lonely. Down the street, that's the way to treat a friend. Right before me, the sun's imploding. Heaven needy, show them the way. And I think it's going to rain today.
Tiger.
burning bright. I'm so hungry, so hard I could not see.
Shot clock and a game clock, and they don't want that. But to me, it shows wit. It shows you've done your homework. Because when you see people running around the table and they have this quizzing look about them, it's because they don't know. And spectators shouldn't be exposed to that. You should be doing your homework, basically. So. So to me, having a shot clock and a game clock, it shows that the game has some education behind it. You know what I mean?
Right.
But not many people think like I do. A lot of people think, oh, one clock, how could you possibly play with a shot clock and a time clock? You're doing it again.
That's the one game where
it was
really
helpful
from the spectator point of view.
Oh, it's been a huge difference. It's been a great game.
Yeah.
I made one from the lilac tree. Lost my heart in its recipe. It made me see what I want to see and be what I want to be. But I think more than I ought to think. I do things I never should do. I drink much more than I ought to drink because it brings me back. You. I look wild. Yes. Like my love. Or am I going crazy? I'm ready.
That you do this to, and you're going through all of this motion here, and it makes no sense. It just doesn't make any sense. It's telling me that you're not in a spot where you need to be, which is karma. You're playing with way too much energy unnecessarily, and you're not going with technique. When you're looking back there, when you're whacking the walls, when you're moving furniture, that has do you see me doing any of that?
No.
Ever. Have you ever seen me move my chair up to the... Ever.
No.
because I'm concentrating on my technique, my bridge work, my backhand. I'm not over there. I'm not out there. I'm not doing that because the shots ain't calling for that. You have a hanger here that's extremely gentle. It's extremely gentle and soft. And the first thing you're doing is shooting it as if you get this rough approach. You're never going to get to where you need to be there, which is nice, like this. Let the cue down, just like you're turning the power steering. You've got to get to a place where you're getting some kind of feel, because where you're at right now, your cue ball's telling me it's getting very little messages, if any at all. I mean, you came around nice for the 8 off the 6, not because you did it. That was the natural angle. All you had to do was let it ride. It was going to do that. You still didn't control it like you should have. But the thing is this, you have to learn that these are only 2 ounces. And you can't rough 2 ounces up. They have to be done with fingertips. And the problem is you're getting in this area all the time. That's dead area. In bowling, we call it fudging. This is where all the feel is, on the fingertips. And that's why if you see me shooting, you'll see me always trying to get on top of my fingertips on my bridge work and on the backhand. You're doing the same in the front and the back. You're fudging both. So both of them are dead areas, really.
Okay.
Because of that.
All right.
Okay, so there's 3 times we went over the same thing. What would you give that cue ball control? On a scale of 1 to 10, in all earnesty, how much control of that cue ball do you think you have?
The last 2 times, I wasn't trying to go back to that rail. I was trying to go...
Zero.
Yeah.
It's an absolute zero. And that's telling you that your technique, your warm-ups, your preparation are way off.
Right.
You're just looking at this and you're saying, I'm going to rough this up, I'm going to pound it, period. There's going to be no intellect involved here. We are not going to have a break plan. We are not going to control the cue ball whatsoever. We're not even going to give it 1%. That's the message you're giving on that break.
Right.
It's so ineffective, it's ridiculous that you would continue to do it 3 times in a row.
Yeah, I got to break that cycle.
It's not anything other than, look, I've gone over this a million times. Somebody that plays a lot of pool improperly, you ain't breaking that. I can never break you into what I'm talking about. It's impossible.
No, but it's good to hear.
Yes. I mean, if you were willing to throw everything that you got out and stop, like, hitting balls and just working on refining your bridge work and your touches and feels and getting into good firing positions so that you can use information to work with, you know, with a little bit of billiard background, you'd have a lot better, you know, idea. You spend way too much focus on furniture, shock, nothing related to the technique of the game. And that's why you break and like that, because your mind ain't there. You've already used it up with all of this other stuff. Okay, let's see what we got here. This is an easy safety. Let's see how we do. And I'm sure you would have played it like this, right? Uh-oh, if I scratch, it ain't a good safety, is it? I'm supposed to be over here. Okay, don't do anything. Just look at me. How much energy have you put into your bridge work and your backhand and getting into firing positions so far? Because I've seen none.
No, nothing right now. I'm
okay.
Just trying to think of the
And that's exactly what I just told you need to do. And you're doing, again, completely throwing it out and doing your thing again. This is why you cannot teach somebody who's already stuck in their ways. It's not going to happen. Don't move. Don't move. Are your fingertips on the cue stick? No. And that's why you got no chance to get nice touch and feel here. Again, here. Your bridge work ain't too bad because this is in the way and it's giving you better bridge work than you normally would have, actually. Okay, not too bad, but still, again, not nice touch, not nice feel, and again, very rough. You didn't get a really nice, soft look to it, you know what I mean? Again, it's just approaching these as if you're going to whack into these balls when they require such sensitivity. And again, that cue ball had nothing. Had nothing on it. Again. And again, as long as you continue to do this, you're never going to be able to control it. So.
Yeah. I've been holding it in here, so you're saying get it right in my fingertips.
I'm saying that your most feel and touch
and
control is going to be at your fingertips.
Right.
With your bridge hand and your back hand.
Yeah.
And the more you keep going into the palm of your hand, there's no chance you can handle that ball. Nobody could,
right,
actually. Now, if you're shooting one ball, you don't have to use any twists or turns and you finesse it. Okay. It's not like there's not a place for it. But you're not utilizing all of the techniques required on these shots. You're not going with them.
Okay.
You keep going with that same one. Let's see how we do here. Oh, I missed it. Okay. Okay.
But you'll take it. Wow.
Jumped it, buddy. I gotta make that shot. Can't be missing jumps. You gotta make them. Not gonna beat the champions, but a little lucky, I guess. That was a beauty. I heard the rail nicely. That was actually a pretty good shot right there. I'm going to bank it now. I wish I didn't, but I didn't. Here's a good position shot. Get back there. He does it. That didn't come out too good, huh? Kind of jumped up on that, didn't stick it. You wasn't in a good firing position. You were off balance, and you didn't really. Again, you got to learn to use technique on those shots. Good hit. Even though it didn't go, it was a good hit. Not too bad. You see how I shot that nine ball just now? That was technique.
Mm-hmm.
Good bridge work, good warm-up strokes, you know.
I'm watching a lot more than I was in the beginning.
Yeah. Well, I'm out of shape. I mean, I'm ridiculously out of shape.
I don't expect that's going to change anytime soon, although...
I haven't hit any balls since we were assigned.
If I could stop walking like you. Oh, good morning. I'm sorry I didn't check the chat out. Sorry, guys. Thank you, Brian. Thank you. Seven to five Shane right now. Thanks for that update, Troy. I appreciate it. Yeah. Okay. Now what you're seeing me do here is I'm going to use these muscles. You see how I got in position here now? I'm already set. Now I'm getting my aim up and my eyes are going to leave that one ball and go right to the cue. See that?
Mm-hmm.
Do you see how I did that? Now, in your opinion, what would you give that cue ball handle on a scale of 1 to 10?
That was right up there. I mean, parked right in the center. Good shot on the one.
But you didn't see this moving around,
Nope. Spinning. Nope, it just stopped dead.
Now, here's a case where you want to play safe, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this shot here. Is that what you would have done? Did you like that choice?
Yeah. I was thinking of something a little bit different, but...
Well, that was easy to execute.
Yeah. I was thinking of... hitting the one into the five and letting the one stop there so I can control the one and then try to bring the cue ball back.
And this is what happens when you take LSD when you are young.
It's been a long time since I took that.
Let's see if we learned anything on the banks here.
Oh man.
Yeah, see the bridge work there? I was too tight with that. Had I got back and used this bridge where I would have had a little bit more room to manipulate, I wouldn't have had to do this at the end, you know?
Right.
Well, it's good position anyhow, yeah. Play this lefty. Noticing technique every single shot, and you have to be creative with it too. So a lot of times it's not going to be the same bridge work all the time, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I played Ernie over at Steinway and he drilled me, you know. It was really interesting. He actually wanted to up the bet too. Oh boy. Thank you.
That 3.5-inch pocket table, that was tough.
That was a lot of fun, yeah.
Man, you had to be on with your shot. I mean, it had to be so crisp and clean.
I played Barakovich afterwards, one pocket. He couldn't win a game. He couldn't make a ball. And he plays on that table all the time.
Yeah.
That's a great one-pocket table.
Oh, that table was unbelievable.
Here we go. Technique. Again, that's going to give me the heavy cue ball. Do you see the position I'm in? Come on, man. Can you imagine this trophy? Look at this trophy. Does it look like much? Nothing, right? It's marble and brass, right? Yet in 1992, this was an invitational event that I won. In order to play in this tournament, you would have had to have won a Joss event or come in second.
Right.
I won the event. I beat LaScotti and I beat in the finals T.J. LaFlemme twice. T.J. LaFlemme is the one that owns the room that Mike Duchesne in Waterville, Maine, called TJ's. Ever hear of that room?
I have.
Yeah. That was nice. Very nice. This guy can shoot, folks. There's a tournament tomorrow at Amazing Billiards.
Oh, yeah?
Why don't you go over there and win it? No pros allowed. I don't consider myself a pro, but I'm bad. If I'm playing, I'm a top pro. Kibitz in IKEA. Is that what you would have done? Oh, no, don't do that. That wasn't a good shot. My baby's crying, and I feel bad for her because Mommy's not going to be home. She's at the Yankee Down Conference with a booth. It's a kind of burnt me out putting a booth up. 8-6 Shane over Efren. All right, we almost broke that lamp. We're still firing backwards at full blast. I may need extra insurance. Ernie is causing me to get more insurance. All right, what do we got here? I should be out here. Here we go. Warm-up strokes. Let's see what they look like. Oh, man. I want to come around for the six in here, see? But I got to make that ball. I got to play that better, that's for sure. Maybe it was a little too hard. I don't know. Kind of fell out of it a little. Well, 8-6. Yeah, Efren's been dead stroke. So is Shane. They're only going to 9, though, so that means the chain's on the hill. When I was going to Derby, they only raced to 7. Anybody could win that, you know what I mean? But going to 9, it gives you a little bit more room. I think they should go to 11, though, actually. See, that was a beautiful shot right there. You say, well, what made it beautiful? What made it beautiful is this. Oh boy, that's beautiful too. That's what happens when you have a big belly. My poor baby's crying like a little baby. Man. Nothing I can do for her right now. Maybe when you're gonna have to wait, baby. I want position. I didn't get it, but I want it. Boom! See, that's a hell of a shot right there. Nice.
That hurt.
I played it like that. Are you kidding or something? You don't think I was going to miss that shot, do you? Of course. I did that against you in New York, too, about 15 different times. And if you think that that was done unintentionally, you might make a bet. You know? Wow, it's still 8-6. He's on the hill. Let's put it that way. He's on the hill. And it just shows you how great Efren is. Because, you know, Shane's tough at any age.
What are they playing?
What are they playing?
Yeah. What's the event? They playing nine ball, one ball?
Oh, boy, Ernie.
I only want to know.
You're only 3 days behind me?
I probably am, yeah.
Thank you, Pat. No, we've been done with the one pocket and all the other games. They're playing nine ball now. Here we go. Nothing. How much is nothing from nothing?
Look at that. Hmm. Hey, I'm gonna push.
Excellente. I'm not sure what that was all about. Let's just run them out anyhow. And I'm gonna come up nice too. I'm gonna come up right on the money, honey. Save. Yeah, I don't know what to do with her. I'm gonna have to put some gloves on. That's what I'll do. So if she bites me, I'll be a little protected, you know? So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put some gloves on. Oh, this is a beauty. This is what they teach you at Harvard, right here. Okay, folks? All right.
That's deep in the jaws.
And again, chalk in the hand, looking out here, and nothing technically going on here or here. And that's why you're going to end up with poor bridge work and poor handle. Yep. If it was straight, it would have been Should be out. You missed that before you shot it. I got news for you. The great white shark right here, folks, in blue, for the Blues Brothers. Get up, 8-Ball, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, cue ball, don't sell out. Oh, look at this beauty. You know my buddy Saul?
Saul.
Yeah. Saul over. I knew you'd know him.
Yeah, I know him well.
What do we got, Troy? Is it over? Actually, at Derby, they're using the same rack I am, which is the AccuRack that Chris Renfro has at Outsville.com. And that great white chalk is also comes from Chris Renfro, who's down there at Derby working with AccuStats, doing the computer stuff. Here we go. We got our legs in the shot. We're up high. Nice. See that cue ball? Did you see that cue ball? That was beautiful. If I could do that every time, that'd be awesome. Well, I should be able to do that every time, you know what I mean? That's what the technique's all about. Nice cue ball handle there. And you made out okay. I got room. I'm going to overcut it, of course. We've got a little shape here. Can I get by this 4-ball, you think, Ernie? Not like that. No, I could have got by there, but not like that.
Right, that 3 is.
Good try, good position. You could have made that 3-ball from there. Here, I'm going to kick underneath it. Kick the deuce out, and I want my cue ball under here. So that's what I'm playing. Did I make it? Got me. You got me. I got a big belly. Here we go.
Nice out. Impressive, Master.
I don't even remember it. Let's see if there's a final score. Not yet. No comment for now. He's good enough from there to win. 8-6, he gets 8-7. His break? Forget about it. Troy tells me he's seen a guy that came into Sandcastle and he knew me. He said he was a neighbor a long time ago. So he sends me the picture. I'm looking at this person. I've never seen this person in my life. So I says, do you have a name, something? And he said, no, other than he's lost 125 pounds.
Oh, there you go. That'll make a big difference.
Oh, boy. Boy, you're a pretty good racker. I might take you on the road with me to rack for the opponents, of course. Look at this shot. This one here. Yeah. Here you go. I'll give you an easy run, all right? Meanwhile, I didn't come out enough. I left it. Beauty. That kind of position there, you could make a lot of money, honey. Ooh, stuff. I got the U.S. Opens, AccuRax and stuff. I have never taken them out of the tool because if they don't have another U.S. Open, that's going to be a pretty good collectible, no?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't think they will have another U.S. Open, not as we're used to. I think it's just about hit its peak, and now the changes are going to happen. A couple of years too late, but it's going to happen. All right, now if I'm going to kick this, it's going to be calculating my ball speed and my spin. Now, I know I got to hit down there, so it shouldn't be a problem. See what I'm saying? See? Oops, look out! I actually didn't like playing it like that. I liked playing it more aggressively. I don't think I was here, though. Was I? Where was
it? It was lined up with the 9, right here.
All right. Yeah, in a case like this, I don't know what made me go this way. If I had this, I don't know if I had this, so I'm not going to go into it. But I like to create angles and make up my own angle with a lot of draw sometimes. And that would have been one of those cases where I would have went with that. And that's the creativity that you need to use sometimes on your kicks. Okay, you see how you had the Q stick landed here, no follow through, yet you pounded this way so aggressively.
Right.
Instead of out here, pushing this in and shaping around, there was nothing going on with it. And that was the reason.
Yeah, I really wanted to be right here.
Well, you didn't have anything on the ball, sir. The follow through wasn't really great. You know, and again, here again, you're here roughing it up. This is a shot that's going 3 inches, it weighs 2 ounces, and you're pounding it, and there you are, out in Texas. What was that? Let's see if he's broken anything else here. I know he's a little rough around here. But we're going to get more insurance. Oh my God. My poor Sarah, she's crying and beeping and weeping. God bless her. Is this how you want to play this shot? That's like an unmissable right there. That's like an unmissable. There's a bad hit right there. Gotta make that ball. Gotta make that shot. This is a pretty good trophy right here. Nice. That's the kind of shot you want to make. You're a little bit far from your work, but it should be okay. Okay, we're still a little far from our work here, but a little technique draw here might be all right. That should help. That should help. Don't worry about the technique. You don't need it. You hit it good too. But when you're drawing the ball, you need it to go straight back. When you see it fall off like that, then you know that it wasn't really out to the ball like you wanted. Alright, let's see how this looks. Do you see how long I came with that?
Yeah.
That's what gave me the great accuracy here. Let's see again, same thing. See that? Don't allow a miss when you're pushing it in instead of hitting it in. You know what I mean? It's just similar to like putting on a golf green. All right. I don't know if you guys are watching that Great Britain. Well, obviously you're going to watch Derby today with the nine ball. I hope my friend Gary got on. He called me right before I got on the air. And he says, Marty, I need help. I can't get on. I paid AccuStats. I got the launch. I launched the player, and it just keeps turning the wheel, blah, blah, blah. So I says, are you using Internet Explorer? He said, yeah. I said, oh, my God. Who in the world uses Internet Explorer in 2016? Are you serious? That's hilarious.
I call it Internet Destroyer.
Yeah, Internet Destroyer. So I got him on the Chrome. I guess he's probably all set. See that cue ball? Doing absolutely nothing. And now I'm going to run up. Unless you want to double the bet, maybe I'll choke.
Double what, zero?
I never bet zero, ever. Time is the most valuable thing I own. And I spend it wisely, hopefully. My money I would spend wisely. All right, what do we got here? Yep, here we go. You ready? What happened? Oh, don't tell me that. Don't tell me that didn't go. I need the money, honey. Well, this is an easy position shot. Let's see what he does. Keep an eye on his cue ball control here. He's one of the best, especially on these shots. See what I mean? Look at that cue ball handle. Beautiful. Didn't scratch, didn't even come close.
You're so kind.
I am when I'm sleeping.
You know that sarcasm is my first language, too.
You better play the nine then. Wow, he actually did that. He must have a load of money on him. Let me put you behind the nine, because you're a really good guy. You know what I mean? Look at this. I mean, how far off can you be? Come on, man. I leave a hanger like this.
Beautiful shot. Actually, that's great cue ball control. Oh boy, that is not good. Three rails on the side, I want. Nice, that's hit well. That's hit well. Let me show you how to play this shot.
A little help from your friends.
Joe Cocker.
He died just the other day.
Yeah, you sure? Yeah.
All right, Marty, I'm going to break next game.
Sure you are.
I am.
Yeah, Joe Cocker. We all grew up with him. You know? So right now, I'm not getting a lot of feel and touch on the break. I'm just hitting him too hard and stuff. So I'm gonna make some changes. Got to. Do we have a final score on the Efren match, sir? Because I gotta tell you, Efren gets that close. He's dangerous. It's no underdog from there. Here we go. Oh boy. I run him out. That wasn't one of my better shots, that's for sure. No, the screen's not frozen. Excellent shot. I'm not sure what's supposed to happen, but it was pretty good. Okay. Now we got to get position here. Remember that. Anybody can, you know. That's a little short. Beautiful hit there. All right, now I should be able to make this, okay? I'm two rail it in the corner with position, okay? Not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen. All right, run them out. Got to do a better job on that kick. If I did that, you know what my wife would say? She'd say, what did you do that for? Where did I do that for? Okay. Thank you.
is this? Huh?
My prediction was wrong.
What was that, sir?
My prediction that I was going to break that scene.
Yeah, well, you'll wake up soon. It's very...
I think I was just one game off. I think it's going to be this one.
No, I think it's going to be this one, yeah. Whatever you're on, I'll have two. It'll be very difficult for you to win. Not that you couldn't.
I'm coming back right here.
There you go. If I don't break and run out, I'm quitting. Uh-oh, I miscued. Oh, boy, that was dangerous. That didn't sound too good. You know that? That didn't sound too good at all. All right, what do we got here anyhow? Five on the side, right?
Yeah.
Ba 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 ba. What happened? Was that? Oy vey, really? What happened? There's your break and run out. That was with a bad break, too.
Yeah.
I might have to do that again. That looked like your break. I might go with that. That's the only time I broke and ran out.
The bad break?
Yeah.
New technique?
I'm going to go with that break. That's a beauty. Nice. Nice break. That was awful. Now, a little bit of a change in technique made that shot go away, you know? Just a little bit off on the technical end. That's all it took. Any of you guys want to play Ernie, race to 11, you can bet up to 10,000. You think you can beat him? Such an easy shot. What happened?
Awesome shot.
Yeah. I could change the focus on this a little, so I'm going to do it, see what it looks like, just so you guys can get maybe a better look at this. Oh, okay. Actually on in a different camera site. Okay. No, I can't do that focus on when I go to Ustream Broadcaster, which is interesting. See how I get into that firing position? It's called the sit-down firing position. So you want to be sitting and be in that firing position. It's not going to happen if you're looking behind you, though, I'll tell you that. I haven't been very effective on the break. That last break is the first scratch of the day for me. So we're going to make an adjustment. We're just going to square into the one now. Get a little bit more angle. This should be a bomb. Perfect. That's going to be a run out. Yep. This wrap's over. Well, it should be over, I should say. Whether it's over or not, I don't know. It should be. All right, how do we want to go about this? Yeah. Ha, ha, ha. Yep. Good try, though. Let's see if you break good. How you can get such an easy patent, it's almost an automatic run, you know. Mm-hmm. Whoops. Came a little short, you hit that rail first and that kind of blew the angle on English on you. See how nice that looks right there? That's a very subtle shot, but that's done with fingertip ridge work. That's how I was able to execute that. What am I doing? Just for the fun of it? Why did I do that? Who knows? All right, let's see what happened. 9-6, it's over. The guru is defeated by the mentee, Shane Van Boeing. The South Dakota kid has done it again, and he wants that nine ball title. He wants those Moscone Cup points because they don't count in the one pocket, and they didn't count in the banks, and they didn't count in the Bigfoot, but they do count in the nine ball. And who's stepping it up but the South Dakota kid? All right, what do you want to do here? Okay. Let's play it like this. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. That didn't feel good, but I hope when I get my new cue, it'll feel good because I can't wait to get at him. Two Jimmy Whites, 6-pointers, one in Bino with a leather wrap. The other's a Purple Heart with no wrap. Both 6-pointers, two veneers. So there's a little bit of ring work with it as well. Not today. That wasn't even close. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Not that this is a bad cue, it's just not a fitting as much as I'd like. I'll have four shafts to choose. I'm sure one of them will work. But I'll get serious once I get a nice cue. I don't mean a nice cue in the sense of a nice cue. I just mean a fitting cue. Something that's going to be fitting, that I'm not going to be fighting with the cue. Well, Efren's out. Is that his first loss? I bet you it's only his first loss. It might not be, though, because when you have a winner, a buyback, then you could draw the same guy twice in a row. I mean, but you could also have, you know, a loss and play somebody that doesn't have a loss.
Right.
You know, so that can happen as well. All right, run them out. Excellent. I like that shot. Hit hard, and that usually sticks the cue, so it wasn't too bad. I should be able to make this. Nice. Beautifully done. Oh, it is beautifully done. Hold on, folks. We got a safety valve. Well, all I know is Jason is not going to win the all-around. I guess he's in second place, but I don't know where Shane sits in all this. And I don't know where, you know, those other guys that are in the nine ball that are still left in, I don't know, you know, how they're doing. I just know that right now, Jason's in second place, and let me see. Jason's in second place, and Alex is in first place. And he's got quite a lead in second place, so I don't know if somebody can overtake it. But 20,000 is first, and I don't believe second is anywhere near 20. I don't even believe it's... Do you have any idea?
No.
I don't even think it's 10. I think it's like 8 maybe. But I know first is the big money. And he's not going to get that. And I got to tell you, you don't get that many opportunities. He won't have too many opportunities to ever get there. But it would have been a hell of a week for Jason. He made 20. He made 16 in the Bigfoot, and then he got second in the banks. That had to be worth something. And if he had won the all-around, he would have made over $50,000, $60,000 for the week. That would have really been a game changer. Oh, what is this all about? Holy cow. I made the billiard. I don't know what happened there. That thing went away. That's nicely played. It's a little off position wise, but
I still like the handle. It wasn't too bad. All right, we're in the danger zone. Here we go. And... oh, what a touch. All right. Now I can play this around three rails, or I can draw it to this rail and come back over. See that? Oh, my goodness. I don't know, maybe I should have went the other way. Well, I shouldn't be missing those. Nobody should miss those. Now, that wasn't bad. Had a little anglais. That bridge work is so bad that it's so difficult for you to make a ball. Plus, you're jumping, 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 jumping. You got to stick these shots nicely. The problem is that you're not really using nice technique, especially on the rail shots like that. I mean, your chances of making that shot before you even shot it were very low, just because of your technique going into it. You weren't set up nice. You were set up at such a bad angle for the cue ball to be straight was just almost impossible, actually. You know? And like I said before, that kind of bridge work that you used there, we already discussed changing it. Either you go with an open hand bridge or you go with a closed bridge, but you let the cue down, you're in the middle. You're doing neither. And that's why that shot really had no chance. You hit it as good as you're going to hit it, and it didn't go. Actually, you hit it pretty good. But the technique was not adequate at all. Now there I used a little finesse, and I didn't get diddly winks. Huh. Looks like a scratchiola. All right.
Nothing I'm doing is working.
You want up the bet or not? It's up to you.
Yeah, let's up the bet.
Let's double it. I need the money.
Alright, here we go.
There's no money, there's no honey. You're aware of that, right? Yeah, I'm going to take you on the road. The way you rack them, woo, baby, that opponent ain't got a prayer. He ain't got a prayer. Woo-hoo! We're going to do a little manipulating here to put a few racks together. boy. Good position. Good position. I'm going to have to kick it into the six and draw it. Okay. Did I make it? Oh, I almost missed it.
Make it when you're trying to miss it. It's almost not fair.
Nice. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Hurry up, you three horse. Nice. I wouldn't have banked that. That was a tough bank shot. You didn't like it right there? Oh, I'm a good guy, ain't I, when I'm sleeping?
I can get this one.
Not right in. You're going to play this right in?
Absolutely, so I can
nice.
Break.
Nice. Very talented. Yankee Dental Conference is a big deal. My wife's got a booth and a bunch of other people working with her, helping her. And me, I'm like a dartboard if I go there. Boy, that reminded me of a Greek salad for some reason.
Why do I keep on doing that? I'm trying to hit it square and I'm just not doing it.
That rolls out just a little, enough to miss it because of the way I hit it. Too bad, because I wanted to get at that seven. I got news for you. I would have broke them up. Foul! Foul! I'm pulling a Jewett move.
Bob Jewett?
Yeah. I'm going to call a foul, whether it is or it isn't.
I used to converse with him a lot on email.
He's a good player, but I've seen him make so many bad calls. It's like, just sit back as a promoter and enjoy the match because your impact of refereeing is too heavy. Yeah, you want a referee, you want to be there but not be seen or heard. That's not him. Far from it. He called a foul on Johnny, I don't believe it was a foul, but irrelevant, but it did cost him the match. I remember him doing that last year too. I don't remember against actually who he called.
called it against, but I do remember another foul he called it. The guy didn't think he fouled, but. And again, when you have a belly like this, don't think you're going to be able to play pool, because you can't. You got to lose weight. Then you can go play. This is an easy out. Nice. At least you attempt the left hand. That's good. I like that. What would you do here? Would you play the nine after this? Or would you bank it, try to break them? Or go back and forth and break them? I think I'll go back and forth and break them. Not going to happen. Okay, I'm going to play the nine ball. I'm going to play the nine, but I'm going to make the eight. And what's going to happen, it's going to go ball, rail, ball, rail, eight ball, corner pocket. You got it?
Yep, I'm watching.
Okay. You don't mind if I play defense too, do you? Uh-oh, that didn't work out very well. Yeah, there's that bridge, beauty. Well, it should be looking good after that shot. That was a heck of a good one. Here we are at the Rough and Ready Show. Yeah, four rail bank. I wouldn't know. Yeah, that's all right. It's $40. Don't worry about it, all the money you got. Are you shitting me? Here we go. Actually, I bought three of those. No, two. And it was $10. At Braintree. Remember when they had that special? They were giving these lamps at $10. I wish I bought more, because the other one I bought, the bulb went, and that bulb cost like $12.
Good deal.
That was crazy, playing it like that. I'm going to kick it in, though. I'm going to kick it in. I should make this. Let's see how it goes. Uh-oh. That was really rough. You see that chair behind you?
Yeah.
What do you think of it?
Looks like an award chair for being for meritorious service in some company. My dad had one. Actually, he had a rocker from Raytheon.
25 years of service.
All right,
two out of three, and last chance to beat the other couple, okay?
I don't know how long this show's been on, but
let me get my glasses, Troy. I can't see without them.
I was checking the time. Ko Pin Chung is playing Dennis Aculo now. Okay. And for those that don't know, Ko Pin Chung is Ko Pin Yee's little brother.
He weighs like 70 pounds.
Does he weigh that much?
If that.
Here we go. How's that break? Oh no, if I make that, I'm out. All right. Should be able to run these, no? Dennis Aculo's in there, Ko Pin Chung. That means that there's no Americans, so that's good. Jason's gonna like that. But I don't know where they are. Ko Pin Yee, I don't know where he is. I don't know where Ko Pin Chung is and the standings either. I don't know, Troy, if you can find the points on that. If you can find the points, I'd appreciate it. I'll let you post it. I'll cut the URLs off, and we'll kind of take a look. If you can get the standings for us, that would be awesome. Because I have no... Oh, I'm not signed in? Oh, there they are. Just want to see if Jason loses that second position or if it's even possible. Because there's so much money involved between second and third, I'm assuming. All right, when I was younger, this was no problem. Uh-oh, oops, where are you going? What happened? See how I played that? That's a beautiful shot, technically. Because look at the angle. See? Mm-hmm. Rack's over now. I like that. Got to go lefty here. It just makes the shot a little bit tougher. Oh, man. Did I get shape? Perfect. It's not perfect if you don't make the ball, though. Yo, what's interesting is if I go to the Ustream broadcaster, I cannot make any focus changes because the camera's already being occupied and broadcaster won't allow you to use two connections such as once the camera's used for one stream, mm-hmm. you can't mix it and bring it into another, so that's probably but the other thing is this, is when I use this broadcaster from Ustream, I get the better audio because it comes out of the laptop, where the other audio is coming out of the camera is really, it's not that good. I didn't realize that. I'm wondering if I can go on to just using the broadcaster, would I be able to use the audio from the laptop still? I don't know if I have that option.
I think you do.
I would think so too. Very nice break. I mean, it's a good heavy cue ball. And it's great pattern layout here, really easy. But as you know, I only got allowed a couple hours on high definition, so I can't really just waste, but can't use up too much.
Well, I can, but that won't allow me to get any more recordings.
Go help, 1-1.
I don't know, I might go to Romania, believe it or not, just because the wife has a friend over there. And it's from what I was told, the area is really, really nice. And I know the guys running that tournament are great. They really treat the players good.
I used to work with a bunch of people in Romania.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I hired several people in Romania.
Yeah, my wife works with a girl that she likes a lot from there. Oh, it didn't go. Unbelievable. Yeah, I got nothing going on the break. Nothing going on. Ain't nothing going on. It is Hill here at Herman University. Ernie's fighting like a real warrior.
Push.
All right, nice push. Push. That's what my wife says. I says, I'm too old, dear. Okay. Well, because I like you, I'm gonna play this.
I'm thinking. So I was trying to get behind that eight.
How's that going? I mean, look at the shape. Perfect for the combination. Well, we're coming down to the wire. And Rennie has got the lead right now by 2 lengths. Oh, yeah, that's a beauty. That's a beauty. Another shot like that, I should be all right. Wow, that's a beauty. This guy can shoot. I'll tell you, he makes Eagle Eye look sick. Nice. Perfect. Look at this troll. That's as good as it gets, folks. What happened? I hit that. I hit that into the rail pretty good, didn't I? I like the rails game. I gotta put up the Kamui banner. He's back on board. We gotta get the banner up. Forgot about it. Nice. You're the champ. Again, I lose again. It's unbelievable.
My money's on the line.
Yep. Nice shooting. Well, I'll be going to McDonald's. Had I won, I'd be at the steakhouse. But I won't be going to no steakhouse now. I might have to go to Burger King. All right, it's 2:31, which kind of halfway through, I guess, over there at Derby City in Indiana. Obviously, it's not in Louisville. I want to thank all of you people for sharing. Nancy, Salome, thank you, Marty, thank you, Nancy. Thank you for taking care of Bustamante and Efren Reyes, as well as Carlo Beato. Scotty Frost is undefeated. And Shane Van Boeing is undefeated. Those are the guys that are undefeated. So Scott Frost ain't done doing business yet. I don't know where he stands on the points. He might, you know. Z Ting Wu with Jingle Bells. This girl, what is this girl's? That's her sister, actually. Yeah, her name's Jelly. Well, it looks like Scott Frost lost to the Russian as Chinnikov had put the nail to the coffin on him, had him 8-3, and I don't know how it ended, but it appears that Scott has lost, and it appears that we got a winner with Shane Van Boeing. Anyhow, in the seventh round, Roberto Gomez. I guess Roberto Gomez has a new cue by Eddie Cohen, which is pretty interesting, and he's also using a nice case by Molinari and the glove. So Roberto Gomez is giving a shout out to Eddie Cohen, a cue I almost bought as well. Also, a wonderful event going down in Florida, the Florida Billiard Expo. Very exciting to see my friend Joanne Mason back and Ray Martin playing partners together against Buddy Hall, also an old friend, and Eva Mattire as well. So it's a lot of fun going on down there in Florida at the Florida Expo. Really nice. All right, kids. I'm going to run. And thank you for the updates, Troy. Appreciate it. And this is a recorded show, so if you want to check out the show when you got nothing to do, see if you can pick something up. It's always in high definition, that's for sure. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you so much. And remember, we never lose at Herman University because we're always learning.
God bless you and share your love. Thank you so much.